start, please find your comfortable seated position. Have your hands on your knees, thumb and index fingers connect, and they can be palms down or up. And I just signify like the palms down if you're really feeling like you need more grounding. It just kind of helps that energy grounding, or palms up for receiving. Close your eyes. Move your gaze toward the brow point. That is the third eye, anywhere between the eyeballs or slightly above. And when you're new to using this type of gaze or mudra, it can strain your eyes. Think more looking out and forward, like you're looking out through the skull towards one point on the horizon. That should ease it up a little bit. Just keep practicing it, staying inward. We close our eyes a lot in this practice. Our energy follows our focus and our intention, and this is the yoga of inner awareness. We're really bringing that inner awareness in with our gaze as well. Let's ground the body. Find your inner thighs relaxed. Just allow yourself to settle in. And then take a little energy, like pressing down through the hips a bit. Nice. And from there, find a little lift in the low belly, right above the pubic bone, and lengthen your spine up to the sky. Visualize your heart over the bowl of your pelvis, your chin back and then slightly head over the heart. Soft gaze still at the brow point. When you're ready, very slowly inhale into the low lungs so that your belly expands. Slowly inhale, lifting the rib cage, top of the lungs, collarbone spread, and slowly exhale the opposite way down. Press the air out with your belly. But when you're ready, inhale, navel, ribcage, top of the lungs, collarbone spread. Exhale slowly the opposite way down. Keep this breath flowing without pausing at the top or the bottom. Long, slow, deep, rolling, full diaphragmatic breath, Durga breath. Three-part breath. Good. Make sure to keep your shoulders relaxed. And again, just return to that grounding in the earth, the inner thighs soft, and a little gentle pressure down through the hips. It's going to keep your spine tall. Good. Let's bring in a mental mantra. On the inhale, say to yourself, Sat, this means truth. On the exhale, say to yourself, Nam, this means name. Inhale, Sat. Exhale, Nam. I am truth. Truth is my name. More deep breath in as you're ready. And long breath out. And begin to rub the palms together, creating heat, energy, getting our nervous system ready for practice. So we'll be tuning in with Om Namo Gurudev Namo, Adgure Namo, Jugadgure Namo, Satgure Namo, Sigurudeva Namo. Calling upon our higher selves, our teachers, our guides, honoring that connection and placing a field of protection around us. Nice. Separate the hands. Feel that tingling energy. Close your eyes here and feel your hands slowly moving towards each other, feeling that exchange of energy. And bringing the palms together once the fingers touch, press them together. Find your center here. We're going to focus on that a lot today. The neutral mind. centering in about 5 to 10 pounds of pressure, thumbs to sternum, elbows out wide. Deep breath in and exhale. Inhale. The eliminative energy of long, slow, deep breathing. If you're not sure how to do breath of fire, the easiest way to learn, just relax your belly and pant. Keep panting. Just find a nice relaxed rhythm. Your body is making its own rhythm. And then when you're ready, close your mouth and pant through your nose. Eyes still gently focused to the brow point. Find your mental mantra, Satnam, Satnam, Satnam. Find it helpful to root down through those hips. Like we've already practiced, notice how your heart gets lighter. So that root down, rise up is a big component in this part of the practice, in ego integrative, creating that pressure through the hips and feel the heart get light, and then reach out. You're opening your chest, you're opening your lungs. This rhythmic breath is giving your lungs a nice massage here. It is highly detoxifying, energizing, alkalizes the blood, oxygenates all your tissues. This pattern breath resets any patterns that might be going on in your mind. So if you want to change a habit in your life, integrate this practice. This will help you. You can do it as many times as you like, 3 minutes at a time. Satnam, Satnam, Satnam. If it starts to get hard, lift your arms up and imagine that you just relaxed there. Keep the breath going. Do your best. Good. Big inhale. Pause the breath, touch your thumbs over your head, just try to feel it. Reach your fingers up, chin in, eyes closed, root lock, root down through the hips. Lift energy up, reach up. Good, and then as you exhale, slowly sweep your arms out through the sides. Imagine you're clearing out your energy field, wiping it clear, leaving behind bright light here, just slowly, slowly, slowly. And then once your fingertips touch the floor, bring your hands to your knees, pause here with your eyes closed. Still sitting up nice and tall, a nice calm place. Observe your energy. Observe any sensations in the body, your breath, your thoughts. And then slowly open your eyes. Let's come to all fours and begin cat-cow. I'm going to continue to try to hook up my stereo here. So hands under the shoulders, knees and feet hip width distance. On the inhale, your belly is down and your head is up. And then on the exhale, tuck your chin and round your spine. Inhale, sat. Exhale, nam. Moving rhythmically here. Opening up the spine. If you have tender wrists, you can always come up on your fists. One key component here is weight placement, even weight between the hands and the feet. So pointing those toes and really rounding the shins can give you some nice leverage. Find your rhythm, find your flow. It's a little faster. Maybe you would do it in a Hatha yoga class. Starting to open up and get the fluids flowing. Find that balance. You're balancing here and get a neutral mind. Neutral mind is the place from where we want all of our decisions to come from. This is the place that the yogi cultivates. It is a storehouse of neutral information. So the neutral mind takes information from the sensory system, the ego, computes it, and from there, that's where you want to make your decisions, a response rather than a reaction. Keep it flowing. Inhale, sat. Exhale, nam. So as you practice today here, find a balance of breath and movement and equanimity in just the way that you notice yourself in your mind. Thinking as you practice. Notice when you become reactionary, or notice when you check out and come back to your center. So you're also thinking of neutral mind as your center, really, really grounded. Another aspect of neutral mind is the heart. The heart is your energetic center. It is the bridge between the lower energies and the higher energies. Breathing into the heart, flowing here. Okay, yogis, inhale, center. Tuck your toes, hips back to the heels, reach forward. Stretch. Push the mat away. Feel those hips get back to the heels, stretching your toes. Then as you're ready, or if you like, take your hands over to the right. Opening the left side body. Press the mat away. Left hip to left heel.
Set your attention.
Stretch into that shoulder. Relax your face, stay centered. And then as you're ready, walk your hands back to center on your inhale, and then over to the right. Right hip to right heel, open and lift the right side body, breathe into it. As far as you can, get a nice wide base for your down dog, and then as you're ready, Take the knees off the mat, relax your head, hips back, and let's walk it out. Back into your long, slow, deep breathing. Shake your head here. Just let it go. Maybe some exhales through the mouth. Good. Let's feel our hands grounded. Face knuckles of the index fingers and thumbs. Wrap those inner armpits towards each other, lifting up your armpits. Lift those hips back and up, right in the middle. And you're going to try to get your weight even between your hands and your feet. Find that middle place. Maybe you have to bend your knees a little to do it. One more deep breath in. As you exhale, bend your knees, look forward, step up to the top of your mat. Feet separate, hip width or wider. Bend your knees and fold. Rub your elbows over your head. Nice sway here. Maybe some more exhales through the mouth. Don't be afraid to bend your knees so that your pelvis can roll forward. That means those sits bones lift up. Nice. There you go. So release your little bind there. Bring your hands to your hips. Bend your knees. Lift your chest up. On your next inhale, press yourself up to standing. We'll take a few rounds of sun salutations. Your feet can be together or apart, depending on what feels more stable for you. Inhale, reach up overhead. And if your neck feels okay, look up. Forward fold. Exhale. Bend your knees as much as you need to. Good. Inhaling, lift your chest up to a half forward fold. Your fingers can be on the floor, even on your shins. Bend your knees as much as you need to get a flat back. On your next exhale, fold forward. And then reach up high, reach forward or hands to heart so you don't hit your neighbor. Good, forward fold, exhale. Half forward fold, inhale, lifting the chest. From here, you're gonna step back to your plank. So any of you that want to modify or chill it out a little bit, you're just protecting yourself from injuries or working on strength, put your knees on the floor. Your shoulders can be over your wrists here. Firm the thighs. We're just going to hold here and breathe. Make sure you're breathing. Come back to that breath. Let's hear them breathe in this pose. This is a power pose. You've got to breathe to give yourselves the energy to do it. Good. Kick back through the heels and draw energy right into that low belly. Head up in line with the spine. Good. Lift your back ribs and your shoulder blades, looking forward. Extend the line of energy out through the crown of your head. Hold that line. Ground the base knuckles of the index fingers. Keep them grounded. Inhale, come forward on the toes. Exhale, slowly push yourself down. Put your knees down if you need to so that you don't collapse in your shoulders. Point your toes. Elbows to the sides. Cobra. Inhale, lift your chest up. Good. And from here, tuck your toes down, dog. Exhale. Breathe. So we're going to do a few rounds like that, and you can modify, you know, those low planks, those chaturangas, those push-ups. You can always just have your knees on the floor if you need to. You can lower all the way down. We'll step it up a little bit for those of you that want it. One more big inhale here. Exhaling, bend your knees, look forward, step or float up to the top of your mat. Come into your half forward fold in the inhale. And forward fold, exhale. And then we're gonna reach up high, reaching forward or hands to heart, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Half forward fold, inhale. Step back to your plank again. We're gonna hold again, just breathing here. You can have your knees down or knees up, head up. You're looking slightly forward here. Good. All right, round the base knuckles, lift the back ribs into the shoulder blades, firm belly, firm thighs. Inhale, come forward. Exhale, push it down, yourself down halfway, chaturanga, or all the way down. From here, find your up dog, maybe, or stay with that cobra. Big inhale, shoulders back. Good, and then down dog, exhale. Relax your head. Chin feels like it's lifting towards the chest here. Lift out of your shoulders. Bend your knees if you need to get the spine long. An even weight between the hands and the feet. Find that middle ground. One more deep breath in. Exhale, bend your knees, look forward, lightly step or float up, that's in your practice. Half forward fold, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Reach up high, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Half forward fold, inhale. Now we're going to speed it back. Step back, lower down, and we exhale. Up dog or cobra, inhale. Good. And down dog. Exhale. Bring your feet together. Right leg lifts up, big inhale. Bring the knee to the nose as you roll forward to a plank. Do your best. Step for step, step that right foot up. And then left heel down, two heels in one line, back foot turned in. Come on up. Arms up. Just pausing here for a moment, breathing into your body. Maybe lift those toes so you can lift your arches and activate your feet. Good. Easing the right hip back, left hip forward. You're just trying to square up a little more to the front of the room. And make sure that back foot's turned in 45 degrees. That's going to help you get that hip forward. All right. Press down through the legs. Feel a nice lift through the waist. Arm bones in their sockets. If it feels okay, look up. If that feels okay, bring your hands together. If it's tense or tight, don't do it. Maybe bend your front knee a little more if you can keep your alignment. Press up through the fingers. One more deep breath in. On the exhale, take your vinyasa, high plank, low plank. Good. From there, find your back bend. Inhale. And down, up. Exhale. Left leg up, big inhale. Knee to the nose, rolling forward, exhale. Now step or step, 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 do your best. Right heel down, right foot turn in 45, two heels in one line, come on up. So I always advise not to bend that front knee as much at first, just so you can ease in. Nice, maybe lift those toes, activate the arches, feel the activation through the rest of your body when you activate your feet. Good. Right hip back. Excuse me, left hip back, right hip forward. Lift through the waist. Heart light, arm bones in the sockets. If it feels okay, look up. If it feels okay, palms together. Maybe you can bend the front knee more if that's in your alignment. Keep the breath steady. Find that nice lift through the navel, your center. Big inhale. Hands through heart, high plank, low plank. Exhale. Up dog or cobra, inhale. Good, and down. Exhale. Relax your face. Imagine roots from your hands into the earth. And you're simultaneously drawing energy from the earth up those roots. Good, all the way up the spine, into the low belly and the hips. And then shooting that energy down into the feet. Rooting down through the heels, even if they don't touch, you have roots on the feet as well. One more deep breath in. Exhale, bend the knees, really ground your hands, lightly step or float up. Half forward fold, inhale. Forward fold, exhale, coming into Utkatasana. Hips down a bit, arms up, biceps by the ears. If you have to bend your elbows, then bend your elbows, that's fine. Good. Peek at your toes. If you cannot see them, bring your knees and hips back. Get your weight in your heels. Maybe lift those toes a little and feel it. Good. Now relax the toes. Another point here. If your feet are apart, make sure your knees are stacked over your ankles. Push down through your legs. Really firm that connection to the earth. And take your energy right up into the low belly. Get your heart really light. No tension in the shoulders. Let your arm bones rest in the sockets. You're breathing here. If it feels okay, look up. If it feels okay, bring the hands together. Good. Settling in here. Breathing. Make sure your hips are back. You don't need to tuck your tailbone in this one. Bring the hips back. There you go. One more big inhale. Reach up. And then hands to heart. Forward fold. Exhale. Half forward fold. Inhale. Step or float back. Lower down. Exhale. Up dog or cobra. Inhale. Down dog. Exhale. Bring your right leg up nice and high on the inhale. Bring your knee to your nose as you exhale. Step it up, warrior one on the inhale, flowing. Good. High plank, low plank, exhale. If you need to take extra breaths, that's fine. Up dog or cobra, inhale. Down dog, exhale. Left leg up, inhale. Knee to the nose, exhale. Warrior one, inhale. High plank, low plank, exhale. Up dog or cobra, inhale. And down dog, exhale. Breathing here, slowing down the breath, focus on your exhales. And again, if the practicing sun salutations is new to you, and you need to take extra breaths, please do so. You want to keep your equanimity, your center. And in like a scientific language, you would say that is your parasympathetic nervous system. You want to stay calm. Deep breath in. Exhale, bend the knees, look forward, lightly step or float up. Half forward fold, inhale. And forward fold, exhale. Utkatasana, inhale, sitting in the chair. Good, forward fold, exhale. Half forward fold, inhale. Step or float back. If you float back, you gotta do it into chaturanga with your elbows bent. Exhale. Up dog or cobra, inhale. And down dog. Exhale. Right leg up, big inhale. Knee to the nose, exhaling. Step it up. Warrior one, inhale. Hands to the heart center. We're going to transition to warrior two, exhaling. So widen your stance. The stance is a little wider than warrior one. Heel to heel, I prefer. And then your back foot's not turned in quite as much. It's a little more on a 90 degree angle. Good. Soft gaze out over the right middle finger. Good. And then from here, you can bend that knee if you like. Make sure your knee is over the ankle. So press that knee towards the right pinky toe. It's okay if the left hip pops forward. All right? Just let your hips feel good here. Straightening the spine. If you feel okay, bend your front knee a little bit more. On your next inhale, reverse that warrior. Good, straighten the front leg as you exhale. Arms out parallel to the floor, inhaling, reach forward. Stretch, push that left hip to the back wall. Bring your right hand down to your shin or the floor, or even up higher if you need to just have your hand in your thigh, that's fine. Reach the arms away from each other. Find a comfortable position for your neck. So if you need to look down or to the side, or lastly up, find what works best for you and what feels good. Keeping your equanimity. Good. Lift the toes a little. Activate those arches. Maybe a little micro bend in that front knee so you're not hyperextending. Feel the thigh bones lift the hips as you lengthen your spine out parallel to the floor. A little tuck of the front ribs in so you can draw the shoulders down away from the earth. Good. Reach more. Open the heart. Good. One more deep breath in and a long breath out. On your next inhale, pull yourself up to standing with the left hand. Good. And then you're going to have your hands to your hips. Turn your right toes into the center. So your feet are parallel to each other. Inhale, lift your chest up. Exhale, fold forward from the hips. Bring your fingertips to the floor under your shoulders. Inhale, chest up, flat back. Exhale, fold forward here. So you can have your fingertips on the floor, arms straight. If you have the room, you can start to walk the hands back until your fingertips are in line with your toes. Keep your hands shoulder width apart, elbows stacked over the wrists. Lift the shoulders up away from the ears. And maybe bend those knees if you need to get a better hinge in the hips. Maybe the crown of your head comes to the floor. Hug those elbows in over the ribs. Get your core solid. Maybe you want to do a tripod headstand here. Just a little energy boost. And your tripoders. Nice, Sonia. Good. Maybe you want to just start playing with tripod. Lift one heel at a time off the floor. Start playing with that. Good job, tripoders. Let's bring our feet down to the floor. Everybody, ground your feet. Little micro bend in the knees. Bring your hands to your hips. Inhale, slowly rise up. Turn your toes out slightly here. Good. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, hands down to the heart center and sit into a squat. Good. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands to heart center, squat. Let's do a few more of these. Sweeping the arms out to the side.
Lengthening the spine out parallel to the floor. tuck the front ribs a bit towards the navel so that you can shrug those shoulders down away from the ears and find length in the spine. And reach your arms. Big stretch. On your next inhale, pull yourself up to standing. Bring your hands to your hips. We're going to take those left toes in, feet parallel. Interlace your fingers behind your back. Bend your elbows here. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Down and back and lift the chest. Inhale. Fold forward from the hips. Exhale. Keep your elbows a little bent. Often when people squeeze their arms straight, their shoulders won't roll forward. So we're focusing on the chest. We don't care how straight your arms are. We care about your spine. Bend your knees if you need to create the forward rotation of the pelvis. Good. Heart reaching forward and relax your face. Relax your head. Nice. Maybe check those feet again. Maybe lift those toes so your arches are active. You're grounding into all four corners. You might have to bend your knees a little to do that. That's fine. Now relax your toes. Feel the strength of your thighs. As you press the hips up, find that midpoint of length. Keep your heels rooted to the earth as you shift your weight towards the front of your feet. Feel the spine elongate and the pelvis roll forward. Good. Keep that little bend in the elbows. Take a little micro bend in your knees. On the next inhale, pull yourself up to standing. Good. Bring your hands to your hips. Turn the left toes forward. Step the right foot in a bit if you need to. Back foot turned to 45. Square the hips. Take the bind that works for you. Right? Whichever one you did last time. Chest open, shoulders back. Inhale. Exhale, pull forward from the hips. So you can check in the mirror. Get those hips aligned at first. Good. And then release. Now is a place where you can close your eyes and feel the breathe. I encourage a bend in the front knee at first so you can really get those hips aligned. Feel your body weight in that front foot. And then push down and forward through the foot to ease that left hip back enough. Right hip down forward a bit. From there, allow the spine to elongate. So if you're jamming your legs super straight and your back is bunched up, that front knee is the giving point. You can bend that front knee a little. Relax your face. Each exhale, pressing that front leg maybe a little straighter, focusing on your exhales. Good. One more big inhale. Exhaling, bend that front knee, unwind. Take your time coming to your plank. And you can take a deep breath in here. You can take your vinyasa. You can skip it. Let's do it. And we'll meet in down dog. Breath is steady. Nice job. Great. Deep breath in. Exhale, bend the knees, look forward, ground the hands, step your foot up to sit. Good job. Let's start the Kriya. Hands on your knees. Creepy grind. Inhale, push the chest forward. It's in a back bend. So you got to start from the pelvis. Exhale in a circle to the left. Pull the belly and round it. Inhale forward. Exhale back. And you're moving through the pelvis. And you're really squishing your belly. Right? Once you've got it, close your eyes. Inhale, set. Exhale, nod. Find a nice rhythm inhale. Let your breath pull you around in this rotation. Start to feel a little heat in the belly. See if you can find that still point within, that balance point. Inhale, set. Exhale, down.
verbalized, discussed, and can only be done. Keep that inner gaze to the brow point, bringing your energy within. Just remember, as an encouragement, when you keep your eyes closed, your energy goes where your focus goes. You keep your first goal. Bringing that intention into you.
Play with it. Sometimes they do say, but
Ananda, root lock is in your practice. See if you can just apply a light one. Like find that little, it feels like the pelvic floor is nice and lifted as you move here. If that's not something that you can bring in to your practice without tension, then don't do it. Just find that equilibrium. Find your equanimity. See where you can find that even when you're being challenged. Sometimes it means you need to rest and visualize yourself doing it. Sometimes you need to just relax and go with the flow.
This is it on the water now. It's so big, so beautiful in liquid. Siamo doing it on one side, but we're all about moving energy here, so that's the point.
back to cross-legged position and watch me first. So we're going to do an arm exercise. Anytime we focus on meditative mind, which corresponds with the heart, arms. So I'm sitting down and really pressing through my hips. Notice what happens. If I'm kind of slumping down, my shoulders go forward. I try to hold myself up with my shoulders. So really rooting through the hips so I don't have to do that. Shoulders are relaxed. And I'm going to have my arms curl over the floor, five fingers together, palms facing. I'm going to lift one arm up, inhale, exhale down. Wait, other side. Make sure you only lift your arm up to 45 degrees and down to parallel. You're going to find in order to be really vigorous with that, you have to push down through your hips. Feel that? And you're pumping the breath through the belly. Your belly is really strong here. Good. Keep the shoulders relaxed as much as possible as you move the arms up and down. Use your hips. Use your navel. Pump the breath from the navel. Nice. Find your rhythm. Find your pace. You guys are doing awesome.
45 straight up or?
Nope, that's 90 degrees.
Okay.
Right in the middle. I guess it just depends on where you're taking the angle from. Find your rhythm. Maybe a little soft turn up on the corners of your mouth. Keep your elbows straight. This is a real struggle. Visualize yourself doing it with grace and ease. See yourself doing this with ease. Even if you rest, take a break if you need to. See yourself doing it with ease and then come back to it. All right, breath of fire. This is a long set. Move through it. See what happens on the other side. Still moving your arms up and down, but you're doing breath of fire. It's a little weird. It's a little shift in coordination. And you're now breathing faster than your arms are moving. Nice. Funneling energy into the heart. Visualize that now as you're moving your arms, that you're funneling energy from the collarbones right into the heart. Heart-centered energy is often green, so maybe it's a nice green, glowing energy that you're funneling in, and your breath is infusing your heart. You're healing your heart here with this breath. So focus inward, brow point. We're gonna go one more minute. You've got this. You made it this far. Keep going. Notice when your mind starts going, what the heck? Find your center place. That's where you watch, observe, see. See if you keep going, even if it's mentally you're going. Almost there. You were resting, so you can come back and finish strong. Good. Inhale, arms up to that 45 degree angle. Pause. And exhale. Nice job, everybody. Reach forward into your down dog for a little stretch. Alright. Now we can transition a few ways. Look forward, bring your thumbs together, your thumb tips together in the front of your mat, like so. Inhale, exhale, you can bend your knees as you look forward and hop the feet to the outsides of the hands or just
step up. Or step, 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 step up. Whatever's gonna work best for you. Let's come to standing. Widen your stance. Get a good wide stance, about 3 to 4 feet. Turn your toes out. Remember that squat we did earlier? Come on down. Arms out, curl over the floor, palms forward. Push down through the legs. So notice if I'm not pushing down, my shoulders roll forward. Kick down. Get your chest up. Close your eyes. And breathe. Long, slow, and deep. And you might have periods here where you don't bend your knees as much. All right? When it gets hard, maybe ease up on the depth. Breathe here. Imagine you have roots from your hips down, your legs, into your feet, down into the center of the earth. Best position to protect your knees is weight in the heels, so maybe lift those toes. Feel it. Eases the hips back. Don't tuck your tailbone ever, that's going to hurt your knees. Stick your butt out. There you go. Isn't that so better? And your feet are 45 degrees, not totally screwed out. There you go. All right, now we're going to say breathe. You got your shape. Forget about the shape. Focus on your breath. Focus on the energy, the strength of the legs, drawing energy from the earth, up the spine. Heart super light. Keep opening the heart here. Drop this. Deep breaths. Spread the heart open. If you start to feel the shoulders take over, push down through the legs. Heart light. Corners of the lips turn up. Palms face forward. 5 fingers together.
Moving around in a circle. Nice.
out, lift a strong root lock. Lift shoulders back, chest up. Good. And then inhale, sit on back. And bring your legs out in front of you. This next one. So the pose looks like this. Not everyone can do this, but it will look like this. And you will inhale leg up, exhale down. All right, so a lot of us are gonna be like, okay. So lift the left leg up to your degree. All right, maybe you can grab your foot. And then you're gonna point, flex those right toes. And then you might be bent. Inhale up, exhale down. It's a balance. If you need to lower the leg all the way to the ground and then lift it up, do so.
Use your low back because those hip flexors are going to be like,
what?
Okay, switch sides. Okay, here we go. There we go. A little smile on your face. Try to ask that low belly to make a lot of this movement. Nice. Find the balance. Even if it means you gotta bend your knees a little, we're focused on the breath and the movement. We don't care about perfect poses. Save that for Instagram. Let's go.
Weight in the heels, eyes closed, find your root lock.
Hug the outer ankles in, lift through the pelvic floor, chest up. And exhale, sweep the arms out, fold forward here. And stretch for a moment. Whenever you're ready, come seated. And you'll sit, simple seated pose. If you have a blanket or a block to sit on, I do advise that because you're going to meditate. All right, Shabda Kriya. So this is a wonderful meditation for the neutral mind. It's wonderful to do before bedtime. This is one of those nighttime meditations that just really calms you and brings you to a peaceful place. We're going to use the mantra Sa, Ta, Na, Ma. Those are the seed sounds of Sat Nam. Sa, Ta, Na, Ma, infinity, life, death, and rebirth. And Wahe Guru. Wahe Guru, wow! The ecstasy of moving from darkness to light. This wisdom brings bliss, indescribable bliss. Wow! The cycle of the universe. Wow, okay. So the mechanics of it are, your eyes will focus at the tip of your nose, with, they're almost closed, all right? So you're gonna have that gaze. Your right hand will be in the back of your left, you'll sit, and you're going to inhale four sniffs, thinking sa, ta, na, na, okay? And then you're gonna hold your breath in, and you're gonna repeat sa, ta, na, ma, four times. Then, after you've repeated it four times, you're gonna have a two-stroke exhale. The first exhale is wahe, the second is guru. And you are sounding this in your head. It's a mental vibration, all right? So, four-stroke inhale, sa, ta, na, ma. Hold as you repeat Sata Nama four times, Sata Nama, Sata Nama, Sata Nama, Sata Nama, and then two stroke exhale, Wahe Guru. I'll show you what it looks like. The back of the right hand and the left. Make sure you sit up tall. There you go. All right, relax your shoulders, relax your face, soft gaze to the tip of the nose, and think forward and out towards one point rather than eyeballs in because that hurts. And begin, four stroke inhale. Hold the breath, Sata Nama, Sata Nama, Sata Nama, Sata Nama. Two stroke, Wahe Guru. Four stroke inhale. Hold Sata Nama four times. Two stroke exhale. That's it. And as you do this, you're going to
place where you allow, you've done a lot. This is a place where you let go and allow what you've done to now work for you. Shavasana. Resting pose. It's actually dead body pose, so allow your body to just let go, basically. And this is the balance you create as you're letting go, so that you can incorporate what you've done and arise with new, fresh energy. This is the most important pose of all, the non-doing. Let your feet fall open, your palms face up. Relax the center of your forehead. Just find a place now. Commit to it. Just fall in, fall in. Relax the root of your tongue. As you relax, you might notice areas of tension or anxiety that pop up because we store that in our body, and it's not bad when it comes up. It might feel not so comfortable, but my best advice I can give is to relax even more, acknowledge it, give it a big hug, and then allow it to move through, because your body's not meant to hold that. Let it go. Let the earth take it and compost it, grow some flowers. Let it go. Be soft. Thank you. fingers and toes. Beginning to hold the ankles and wrists. Open around one direction and then. Then as you're ready, reach your arms over your head, point your toes, take a deep breath in and stretch. Good, and draw your knees into your chest, a little shimmy shimmy on the backs here. Optional twisting, as you exhale, drop your knees to the left, turn your head to the right. Take a deep breath in here, and exhale. When you're ready, lift your knees to your chest, and take your knees to the right. Inhale and exhale. Lift your knees back up. Start to rub your palms together, widen the knees so you can rub your feet together. And go. Stimulating the nerve endings again so your nervous system is ready from getting up and going. Ready up and go. Alright, bring your knees to your chest. You can rock up or roll to the side and come up. Press our palms to the heart center, feeling that deep connection to the heart. This mudra, Anjali mudra, is a neutral mind mudra. It is supposed to balance both hemispheres of the brain or bring at least some kind of energetic balance and center you. May the long time sun shine upon you, all love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. Let's finish with three long satnams. Questions, please ask, and I hope to see you soon.